From the Tribune News Network, this is Newsbreak. I'm Krishna Russell. Regulators last night pledged to investigate Cable Bahamas' TV service quality and said they were majorly concerned by the length and frequency of outages suffered by customers. The Utilities Regulation and Competition Authority, in announcing it has approved the restructuring of REV cable TV packages, said it was unable to ignore recurring complaints from Bahamians about service interruptions and other issues. Reporting on the replies received to the REV package restructuring consultation, complaints regarding Cable Bahamas' service quality was a recurring theme in the responses. In addition to public complaints, IRCA is aware of persistent and wide-scale service interruptions in the form of error messages consistently appearing on screen, regular service outages at 2 a.m., pixelated channels, and other issues. The communications industry regulator urged Cable Bahamas customers to bring such issues to its attention via its complaint handling process and added that its quality of service regulations may be able to redress some of the problems. However, IRCA did not do what many had urged in their feedback and require that service quality issues be addressed before it approved Cable Bahamas' REV channel package restructuring and any associated price increases. Amid growing social unrest in Haiti following the assassination of Haitian President Jovenel Moïse, local law enforcement officials plan to deploy additional vessels out at sea to prevent any potential mass migration of Haitian nationals to the Bahamas. Royal Bahamas Defense Force Commodore Raymond King told the Tribune yesterday, "The Royal Bahamas Defense has taken the position to strengthen our strategic posture in the southeastern Bahamas. We intend to allocate 3 42-meter vessels as well as an enduring friendship vessel, which we refer to as a strike boat asset. Also, we have an air asset. One of our aircraft will be deployed to that area to provide intelligence, surveillance, and reconnaissance to support our four vessels in that area." Commodore King spoke after Foreign Affairs Minister Darren Henfield revealed on Wednesday that the Bahamas had closed its embassy in Haiti in response to the nation's deepening crisis, noting it will remain shut until a way forward is determined. Pan American Health Organization officials have revealed that the deployment of COVAX-issued vaccines was delayed in June due to a myriad of issues experienced by the group with Oxford AstraZeneca production sites. Dr. Jarvis Barbosa, PAHO Assistant Director, made the announcement earlier this week at the organization's weekly webinar designed to update the region on the fight against COVID-19. 17 countries in the region are expecting to complete the third wave of deployments of vaccines from COVAX. Dr. Barbosa said the main problem is the government of India is not allowing the Institute of India to export the Oxford AstraZeneca vaccines. After much backlash, officials have scheduled a two-day event at the end of the month to showcase performances by local artists. In celebration of the country's independence, Minister of Youth, Sports and Culture Iram Lewis announced yesterday. The event will take place on July 30th and 31st and will involve 48 artists in recognition of the country's 48 years of independence. This comes after some Bahamian artists expressed displeasure over this year's independence celebration, leaving out a mixture of top local secular artists in favor of a Christian theme. They also complained the songs scheduled to be used in the event were not locally written or produced. At a press conference, Mr. Lewis said the upcoming event will be live streamed for its viewers. Your complete news and information source, this is the Tribune News Network. In international news, Haitian authorities have made more arrests in the assassination of President Jovenel Moïse, raiding Taiwan's embassy where several suspects are believed to have sought refuge, while also detaining two Haitian Americans and several former Colombian soldiers already tied to the plot. In all, 17 suspects have been detained and another 8 are being sought, according to National Police Chief Leon Charles. "We are going to bring them to justice," he said, as the 17 handcuffed suspects sat on the floor during a news conference Thursday. Several countries around Asia and the Pacific that are experiencing their first major surges of the coronavirus rushed to impose tough restrictions a year and a half into a pandemic that mainly initially weathered well. Faced with rapidly rising numbers of infections in recent months, authorities in such countries as Thailand, South Korea, and Vietnam announced or imposed measures Friday that they hope can slow the spread before healthcare systems are overwhelmed. It's a rhythm familiar in much of the world, where repeated surges deluged hospitals and led to high numbers of deaths. The Tribune's AccuWeather update, a service of Bahamas Power and Light Company. Residual moisture along a trailing rain band associated with Tropical Storm Elsa, well north of the area, will support few showers and thunderstorms across the northwest Bahamas. Meanwhile, building high pressure across the area will maintain moderate to occasionally fresh east to southeast winds, mainly across the central and southeast Bahamas. Boaters, especially in the northwest Bahamas, should remain vigilant for waterspout activity in or near heavy showers and thunderstorms. Also, swimmers and beachgoers, particularly in the central and southeast Bahamas, should exercise extreme caution due to the risk of rip currents along east and south coast beaches. Residents are advised to limit outdoor activity and to remain hydrated due to heat indices expected in the triple digits. For the northwest Bahamas, it'll be a mix of sun and clouds, warm and hazy, with a few isolated showers and thunderstorms possible this afternoon, warm and muggy tonight, with a stray shower or two possible. Gusty winds and higher seas can be expected in showers and thunderstorms. Winds east to southeast at 10 to 15 knots, seas 2 to 4 feet over the ocean. For the central and southeast Bahamas, it'll be partly sunny to sunny, breezy and hazy, with a chance of an isolated shower or two this afternoon. Breezy and warm tonight, with a passing shower or two possible. Small craft operators should continue to exercise caution. Winds east to southeast at 15 to 20 knots, gusty at times, seas 4 to 6 feet over the ocean, higher in gusts. We'll have a daytime high temperature of 90 degrees with an overnight low temperature of 76. The sun will set at 8:01 and will rise tomorrow morning at 6:27. That's Newsbreak. Details of the day's top stories in the Tribune newspaper now on the streets, or stay up to date online at Tribune242.com.